Okay, so students, today we are going to learn Standard 10 Social Science, Chapter Number 1, Heritage of India. When we heard the words heritage, first of all, we learned to this word heritage. Generally, obviously, we know that students are knowing about this word heritage. Heritage means whatever we get or obtain from generation to generation. It is called heritage. And generally, we can see that heritage of different types. Okay, in these chapters, we are going to learn two different heritage: cultural heritage as well as natural heritage. But actually, first of all, if we want to learn the word heritage, so get a proper detail of heritage. So I will give example of heritage. Heritage means we can say that whatever we obtain or get from generation to generation, it is called heritage. For example, we can see that in so many families, a whole family member will be having a specs, okay, because they will get that as their physical inheritance. So heritage is of physical also, materialistic also. Okay, so students, we can understand the words heritage by these two examples, physical as well as you can say materialistic. Physical, I have given the example of family. Okay, so many family members will be having the same disease also. Okay, so many times we have seen that a disease is also inherited from their generation to generation. So we can say that heritage. Or materialistic heritage means what? People get property, money, land, etc. From generation to generation. It is called materialistic heritage. Okay, so we shall start this new topic of the chapter, rich and varied heritage. Okay, we can say that we are lucky to get born in this good and multifarious culture country like India. So I have given some details of rich and varied heritage of India. Okay, so here I have written a little informations, but I will clarify this in detail also. Rich and varied heritage. What is rich and varied heritage? So first of all, I will tell you that our motherland has bestowed which rich and varied heritage to us also and to the world also. Why I am saying to the world? Because we know that peoples of the different countries came to India, settled here for the trade purpose. Okay, so many things they have learned from our side also, and we will learn from that side also. So we can say that this bestowed heritage is given to us also and to the world also. As well as Indian cultures have been a trade oriented and peace loving. We know that in each and every country will be having their original or different heritage. But in India, we can find that trade oriented culture. Now here one more word is added, so we need to understand the word culture also. I underline this word so you can understand. This word is also added. Okay, culture. Now next topic is that Sat, Chit and Anand realized from Indian culture. Okay, so what is Sat, Chit and Anand? So realized from Indian culture, so we can understand Sat, it means Satya, or you can say truth. Chit, it means concentrations, and Anand means pleasures. These all things are realized in Indian culture. Okay, even though values of non-violence and peace, which have been adopted and admired by the world. It means, as we all know that our national leader, or you can say father of the nations, okay, he also adopted the non-violence. Okay, so these two things are found in our culture. It is called non-violence and peace. Okay, now people right from the beginning of Indus Valley civilization to till today have made our country rich and wealthy with their intellectuality, ability, talent and skill. Okay, so before we understood this entire para, I will tell you one more thing. It means people from the beginning of Indus Valley civilization to till today, okay, they contributed a lot and make our country develop. For example, for this I will tell you who made these contributions and who made that our country develop. So I will give examples of that: innumerable scholars, okay, thinkers, artists, artisans, sages, saints, scientists and other historians, those who have contributed to the growth and development of our culture. And because of that contributions, we get this rich and multifarious culture. Okay, in India, I will give examples of some of the you can say mathematicians, For example, you can say Aryabhat, okay, Brahman, okay, Bhanbhat. These all are great persons that contributed immensely and make Indian country developed. Now, if we are going one step ahead, okay, meaning of culture. Generally, we heard this word culture in our society. It means, what is culture? We have heard many times that they adopted the Western culture. Okay, so what is culture? So in short, I will tell you, culture means art of living. Okay, later also we can understood this entire para. Understood. So first of all, meaning of culture, we can understood from these examples also. Culture is sum of habits, values, customs, traditions and conduct of lifestyle of human. It means we can say culture is a one kind of habits. Okay, for example, if we will be having a habits, values, customs, or as we all know that we all will be having the different traditions also, okay, then different lifestyles also. Okay, so this is called part of a culture. In short, we can say culture means way of life. Even though these two definitions are too easy for understanding, okay, culture is the journey of a man from darkness to light. Another one is that culture is the journey of a man from cave to home. Okay, so these are the two important definitions we will be having of culture. Okay, so this, through this also we can understand the word culture. Actually, many times we have heard that, okay, that people have adopted the Western culture. Okay, so what is culture? So culture, we can understood the word culture by that, for example, we will be having different traditions. Okay, we will be having different festivals, so they are celebrating in different styles also. So these are the words which are too much important for our topic: lifestyle, traditions, values, customs, habits, okay, or you can say sum of habits. These are the parts who make the culture. Generally, the peoples are living in one community or one group, but they will be having the different culture. For example, we'll take that example of people. Okay, for example, one religion, but they will be having the different traditions, the different lifestyle. Okay, or you can say they will be having the different rules and regulations also in their family. Okay, for example, they will be, if the marriage is done in a one family with different rituals or traditions, okay, and another same religion family will be having the marriage with the different you can say rites and rituals or traditions and customs or conduct. Okay, so this is the part of culture. Okay, so here we have understood these two words, heritage and later on culture. Okay, I will give a short summary of it. Heritage means, okay, whatever we obtain from generation to generation. Actually, heritage of two types, physical or materialistic. But in these chapters, we are going to learn two different parts of heritage: cultural heritage and natural heritage. Okay, in another video, we'll get the detailed information of these two topics, cultural heritage and natural heritage. But here, I will give short summary of these two topics. Okay, cultural heritage, it means it created by, or it you can say immense by the man. Here man is involved. Okay, these all things are created, or you can say established by man. Whereas natural heritage, from the word also we can understood, it is made naturally. Okay, there isn't any contribution of, or you can say involvement of man is here. Natural heritage is occurs naturally. There isn't any contribution of man, or you can say man is not involved in any activity for establishment of natural things. Okay, so I will give examples of it also. Natural heritage, we can take the example of landscapes, rivers, wildlife, vegetations, desert, forest, etc. Whereas the examples of the cultural heritage is, you can say, fort, palaces, okay, tomb, temple, gates, wow, stepwells, ponds. These all things are created by man, so it is called cultural heritage. So friends, in our next video we'll get the detailed information about the cultural heritage and natural heritage, and I'm sure that you'll be getting the complete meaning of these two topics, heritage and culture. So I hope that you'll get the full idea of it. Now I will give some instructions regarding worksheet. Okay friends, from this part you will be getting worksheet. In that will be having the objective portion also, as well as short question answer will be there. So it's a humble request that you all will be requested that get it in detail also, okay, and make a concentrations for that, for answers. Okay, so thank you.